In addition to other properties, animation clips have curves and events. These are found at the bottom of the Animations tab when you have a model selected in the Project panel. Curves can be used to define values over the length of an animation. For instance, if we had a jumping animation, we could define a height value on a curve. This height value could be set to match the height of the model's torso during the jump animation. We could then retrieve that value in our scripts and adjust the size of the model's collider with it. In this way, the model's collider would accurately align with the model's movement. Let's take a look at how to add an animation curve to an animation clip. Start by expanding the Curves dropdown, then click the plus icon to add a new curve. Next, we should name the curve. For our example, we might name it something like Jump Height. This curve name must also be added as a float parameter to any animator controller that you wish to use the curve on, or else you will not be able to access it. There are two ways of editing the curve itself. Clicking on the image of the curve opens up the curve editor. This is the best way for fine-tuning a curve where accuracy is important. In the curve editor, you can double-click on the line to create a keyframe, and you can drag the keyframes around to the appropriate values. The curve can be reset by clicking one of the default curve values at the bottom. The other method to add values to a curve is to scrub through the animation using the Preview Window's scrubber. You can then set keyframes at appropriate times using the button just left of the curve. To the left of the keyframe button is the value display where you can set the value for that keyframe. Using the left and right buttons below the name, you can move between the keyframes and set their values. Unity will then automatically make a smooth curve between them. If you are blending between multiple clips, each with a curve of the same name, then an average value will be taken based on the weight of the blending. To find the value of a curve in a script, we use the GetFloat function of the animator component. This function takes either the name or the name hash of the curve as a parameter. The return value is the value of the curve at the moment the function is called. For more information on the GetFloat method, getting values from animators, or on animator scripting in general, see the lesson on animator scripting linked below. Events allow us to call functions in our scripts at different points in an animation. For instance, if we have a jumping animation, we may want to play a sound when the model lands. This is easy to achieve by creating an event at the point in the animation where the model's feet land on the ground. To add an event, start by expanding the Events dropdown. You can then scrub through the animation using the Preview Scrubber. Add events using the button to the left of the timeline. This opens a window displaying the properties of the event. The first is the name of the function that is called. This must be a function that is in a script that is attached to the same game object as the animator component that plays the animation. For our example, let's pretend we have a script with a function called playLandingSound. We would type playLandingSound in our function property. The following properties are potential parameters for the function. Only one can be used for a function call. Which is used depends on the parameters of the function that is being called in the event. When blending between clips with events, all of the events will be called, so it's best to keep that in mind. If you were going to use an event to play a sound effect, such as a footfall, you would probably want to limit the number of times it can be played by checking whether the sound is currently playing before playing it again. Otherwise, you're likely to have multiple versions of the same sound playing simultaneously.